right now my background looks amazing and it's just, yeah, it's got a studio. No. Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. Hey y'all, how's it going? Zach here again, and today I'm gonna show you how to use green screen. This is green screen, so as you can see, it says green screen. So what I'll do is I will show you how to set this up and how to get this effect and how to produce videos like right now, like me sitting here and then you seeing it like that. And I'll show you ways we can be creative as well. So the first thing I'm gonna talk about is green screen. Why would you need a green screen? So at the moment, I will explain you my situation. I'm in a very small, tiny place. It's not actually a tiny place, but it's very small. But it's the whole thing is just a one, and if you just wanna have your background to whatever you want, you can. And there's also a lot of other reasons why people want green screen. Like most of Hollywood is green screen now. Green screen is the furthest color away from this color or white color, any color. But you can't only, so there's two colors that, as long as the color's really vibrant, you can use it. So green screen is mostly used, and then also they use, like if say for instance, if you're shooting a documentary in the forest, it's green, then you need to use blue screen. So they do use blue screen as well for certain things, and I might get a blue screen to try on as well near Christmas or something. But so two color options, you could do green screen, or if you're getting it, make sure you know. If you're getting green screen, make sure you remember that. Green screen or blue screen, or get both. And then you can go from there. And then to set all this up, I'll show you how to set it up. So this is how we set it. So this is being recorded from my phone. So I've got this mic should be a bit closer to me, but I don't have this thing is very small, but doesn't matter. So I have got it, this should stop recording now. So I've got the whole camera set up here as well. As you can see, the mic is hooked up and everything. Look, this is very simple. So I've got the window here, like it's really big and bright window. Like here, that's, you know, it's getting a lot of light and coming and hitting the green screen. So, and the camera is just there, and then also got another light source that's coming from that direction. So that comes this way, so hits it right there, and then it sort of gets rid of the shadow. But see how the shadow is created? So you see how the shadow is created there? You don't want that shadow. You want to be at least, because the green screen is a bit smaller, I need to put it up and then I'll get rid of room. So I don't need to use this section. I only use this section and nobody sees that section. So I don't really mind. So that's a trip for you guys if you do use it. All right, so it is very easy and simple to set it up if you're in a small place. All you need is obviously, as I explained, you just need your both side tripods and you need your overhang, and then you just put the green cloth through. So I bought this one from Spotlight, and I didn't even order it online. So you can easily order it on Amazon and everything, which is very easy. And that's that. And now I want to show you guys how to go about editing it, and then how will we go about, you know, taking this green screen out of the frame.
All right, so I've imported the footage into Final Cut Pro, and I've done my editing, and then I do the effects stuff right at the end. So now I'm ready to add the effects to get rid of the green screen. And to do this is very simple. So you would select your footage that you have. So I'm selecting this part of the footage, and then I also have a layer at the bottom, which is going to be the back. So I've already got that sorted as well. So what you want to do is go into your effects browser, which is located on the right side-ish, or you can press Command 5 and you'll actually see the effects browser. So, and then once you come in here, you can scroll down and then you find keying. And then after keying, you want to find keyer. And then on keyer, you can see, and then it will see some, you can see what it looks like. So it cuts it out, get rid of the screen. So you want to drag and drop it right on top of that footage, and then you can see the effect of what happens. So now you have your background as looking like a studio or whatever one you want. So you can take yourself whatever you need to do. So there's also other, you know, there's also other settings you can go and have a look inside here, inside the Cures effects tab. You can do that as well. If you want to turn it off, you can press this here and then before or after to have a look at it. And that's as simple as that. But there's also other things, more advanced features you can actually do as well with this, but which we're not going to get into it. So this is very simple and easy. But if you want me to make an in-depth tutorial on how to use green screen properly with professional lights and stuff, I will do so. Let me know.
All right, so that's all fun. And now that I want to share with you guys is the camera settings. So you could actually, with me, I'm shooting a manual now, so I'll show you guys how this is. So
the camera settings is like, there's not much into the camera settings. So what you will do is actually, so what I'll do is I focus on the chair and then I move the focus a little bit. So I don't want it, I don't want the camera to be in out of focus. And you do want to see yourself because this screen, I can't. If you have a monitor, it's probably easier for you. So do that. But I shoot at, you know, whenever you're shooting with manual with the DSLR camera, it's double your frame rate, whatever. Aperture, ISO, shutter speed. So these will do different things for you. And then ISO auto at the moment. So I leave ISO at auto because the light might change and stuff. So I'll just leave it there. It is. But apart from that, that's the camera setting, and the mic is very important as well if you want a good sound.
But lighting is another thing we're going to talk about next. So with that being said, that camera setting doesn't really matter. You can shoot on auto and it will be fine. But lighting is the most important thing when it comes to green screen and shooting yourself. So right now, I do have lighting, but there's no room to put it up. But this is just for YouTube. As long as it gets the job done, I don't care. But you can actually really go and set it up. But I'll show you in a cheap way, like I am doing right now. You can just easily get away with it and be perfectly lit. So the most important part is the subject, that's me right now, and then the green screen. So with the green screen, you never want shadows. See how there's shadows now? Like if you get too close to it, the shadows, like the computer, the program, the editing program will not be able to remove it. So the shadows you can. So that, you don't want that.
The lighting is really key. So this is the setup now. So I'll show you the whole setup. So I've got the light coming from that direction, and that big window is hitting the screen in my...
And then I got another window here. So that window is hitting light this way and sort of canceling the shadow, but you can still maybe see. So that's how you get rid of the lights in a very cheap way. So you just set it up to this window, more wider open, and then that window as well. And then on top of that, if you want to set green screen up professionally, then you would do a bit of lighting for yourself. So you would need, you can light yourself in a thousand ways. So main light, you can just hit it from this angle and then make sure you have light from the top and then light from the shoulders, from two sides to hit your shoulder like this side. And then you want to have really white lights hitting the back, maybe from the bottom or this, like that direction, because you don't want it towards the camera and you don't want it towards you because it's going to light you up as well. So hit it on an angle to the back and then you can hit it from there, or the bottom you could put a light right behind you to heat it up from here, and then you get it perfectly lit, and then you're away, and then you get perfectly lit, there's no shadows, and then you can be absolutely creative with it. So apart from that, when it comes to buying green screen, I will recommend you just to get any green screen. Really, like, green screen is really hard, so you can get materials, you can get paper, like right at the moment this is just the cloth. So this is like cloth paste I got from Spotlight, and you can get different versions. I'm gonna go get more because that's actually not bad. It's good. So that is very cheap, or you can go Amazon and stuff, and you can purchase really cheap ones from there as well. All right. So here are some of my tips of what not to do when using green screen. So I've been using green screen for a little bit now, and it actually brings out your creativity. And okay, so let's say if I'm shooting this, and if I have a green jacket on, guess what happens? I get green screened out the same that. So make sure you don't wear green at all. And if you're wearing green, you could switch around and put a blue screen on. And then another thing you shouldn't do, don't wear glasses because the reflections, they reflect the camera. Because you know how people wear glasses, like this section here, like you can see through, and it'll be green, and then it will just create chaos for you. There's actually two programs that allows you to do this. I've used it both with Final Cut Pro. I'm using it right now with Final Cut Pro. And also you can use Premiere Pro. So in Premiere Pro, you use an effect called Chroma Key. So there's a lot of gamers, there's a lot of people who do live shows, like TVs and stuff. They all use green screen or blue screen. So if you want to do that, do it live, you can't use Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro. So but there's a few programs that you can use. I think there's a program called XSplit Green Screen. You can use it live when you do gaming shows. And then OBS is one as well, which is free, that I did some streams as well with it, I think previously, yeah. So you can use that as well. All right, so those are a few of my tips and how to use green screen. And if you've got any suggestions or anything, or for me to better use the lighting or anything, please make sure you leave a comment below and let me know. And I'd really appreciate that. So please do so. Thank you so much for watching the video, and I hope you learned something, and I hope you use this If you do use it, make sure you send me your videos on my Instagram at ZachShots, and then I'll gladly have a look through it, and then I'll give you my feedback. If you want that, I'll gladly do that for you. Of course, when it comes to socials, you can follow me on Twitter at ZachShots. You can follow me anywhere. You can follow me on Instagram. You can follow me on TikTok. These are all my socials, so you can go and have a follow there as well. With that being said, thank you so much. I will see you guys in the next one.